unconditional branching using goto statement. See, till now when we used if, else if or we used switch, in all the cases it was conditional branching. That means based on certain condition, which is in case of if true or false, and in case of switch when the value equals to the value in case, we were jumping to a particular block of code, set of statements. But we can use goto and directly jump to a particular location without any condition. So goto statement is used to alter the normal sequence of program execution by transferring control to some other part of the program. This is very important statement. And what is the syntax? We should use goto some label, and then we should give a label name, colon, and then the statement. So ideally I explained this using an example. Let me copy this program as it is. Paste it here. Now let us format it. So what is this now? It's a small dummy program, doesn't really have sense, but still we are doing it through goto. And of course, to only demonstrate the syntax of goto. So I'm reading a number, enter any number. We are reading that number, checking if the division by 2 remainder is equal to 0 or not. If the remainder is equal to 0, we are saying goto label even, that is here. That means from here it will directly jump to this location, print even number and return. But if it is not, it will say go to label and print odd number and return. Now here return statement is compulsory. Why? Because we have given a label to this, it does not mean that this statement is not going to execute if go to label odd is not there. In normal circumstances, it is a normal execution. But when used with goto, it will go to that particular statement and come down again. It's a random jump actually. Ideally, I would suggest we trace this program. So right click, insert a breakpoint and debug, start debug. Enter any number, continue, scan. So now command window will open. At the command prompt, enter the number, let's say 5, enter. It comes back to studio. Now number is 5. Again say step into, it was go to label odd. This condition is false, so else go to label odd. It came here, it executes, we have return and it terminates. Now what if the number entered is 4. Again say step into, it went to this. Now because we have return there, it is terminating from the main. But if return is not here, it would have printed this and jumped to next also. Let me show you that. Stop debugging first. Remove this return, comment it off. Now run the program. Enter a number 4. It will see even number as well as odd number is printed. That's why to break the program here, we have written return. And return, remember, is the last statement executed. Once return, it returns to the operating system. Because I have given return type as void, there is no value. But if you give return type here as integer, both are allowed. Then in such case, you have to give a return value here. Right now, you return anything. What is the significance of the return value? I'm going to speak about it later in some other topic. So yes, a small example just to demonstrate how to use goto with a label. Goto is single word, followed by that we are supposed to give a label, and label has to be explicitly mentioned with colon followed by that the statements, and it's an unconditional jump to that block of code from where the label is defined. Label need not be always after goto. This label I can give even before goto and jump from here back up. So using goto we can randomly jump up or down. Now what is most important is, in the industry it is always a debate whether to use goto or not to use goto. Some people will advise you not to use goto, but when some people advises you not to use goto, why should the language itself have it? When a feature is not advisable, not good, probably the language should remove. Rather, what you should know is, not only C, modern languages like Java and C sharp also have goto. So what is the purpose of goto in today's world when goto in C itself is not recommended? That is wrong. It is not right to say we should not use goto in programming. What generally happens is, when we use goto, we end up making the logic of the code little complex to understand at later point of time. And many people tend to use goto instead of using loops like for loop or while loop, which we are going to learn in subsequent chapter. So we will see that there are many logics which we can very easily write using for loop and while loop. Those things we should not implement using goto. Otherwise there is absolutely no problem with goto. Now let me explain this point to you. Now what I am doing here, reading a number. Now what I would like to do is, if the number is 0, then I will say return goto stop, and this is stop, and terminate the program. But if the number is not 0, I'll say number minus minus. So whatever is the number, I am decrementing that, checking if it is 0. If it is 0, stop it. But if it is not 0, what to do? Number is percentage d comma number. If it is not 0, I will first decrement the number r num minus minus, and here we will say decrement. If the number is less than or equal to 0, then say we are saying stop. But if it is not, we are decrementing. That means we are going back here, decrementing and printing the number. So let us run this program now. Enter a number, say 5. Number is 4, number is 3, number is 2, number is 1, number is 0, and then press any key to continue. Yeah, to get better output, we'll say percentage n. Let us remove this percentage, enter a number, properly format it. Enter a number, let's say 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0, and then terminate it. This logic is not that easy to understand, and I'll show you in subsequent chapter, if similar kind of requirement is there, we can easily write this using other programming constructs which are available in C, that is using while loop and for loop. We can get a similar kind of output with much more ease. That is the only reason goto is not recommended. But if you need goto in a particular situation for randomly jumping from one part of the program to another part of the program, do not hesitate to use it. Precisely syntax is given to you here. So I repeat, do not go by the word that you never use goto in project. What am I saying? Use goto provided you know it is needed, and the same logic we cannot implement using for loop while loop, because any logic implemented using for loop while loop gives more clarity than goto. This is complex. If I straight away ask you to write this
code and straight away ask you to scan this code and give me the output, it's pretty difficult for you. It's not that easy. Even if you trace it, it's not easy because it's jumping. Random jumping is there. So this is how goto should be used, which is unconditional branching. There is no condition, but it is going to a particular part of the code and executing that. Thank you.